It all started in 1978 for Michael Johnson when he recorded what turned out to be a pop and country music hit.
We should be glad that I'm bluer than blue, sadder than sad. You're the only light this empty room has ever had. Life without you is gonna be bluer, bluer than blue. Bluer than blue. Bluer than
beautiful. One of the most compelling voices in country music today, and you'll hear more of it later on stage. Right now, Joe Elmore's back in the green room with Michael, so let's join them. And Joe, I hope Michael brought along his guitar.
Well, he indeed did, Keith, and we're going to try to talk him into giving us a little impromptu performance in a minute. But first, Michael, welcome backstage at the Opry.
Thank you, Joe. It's a pleasure to be here. It's my first time at the Opry.
That's what I understand. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I think it's great. It's beautiful.
When you were growing up out there close to Denver, Colorado, as a youngster, did you ever think that one day you'd be playing at the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville?
No. As a matter of fact, I was kind of a terminal rock and roller there for a while as a kid. So I didn't have any idea at all that I'd be here today.
You've had a great couple of years since you've been here, and you've had an interesting career. You were in folk music, rock and roll, as you mentioned. And 10 years ago, a Bluer Than Blue that we saw a little clip of then was a pop record, a very popular one, and now they're playing it on country stations. How do you feel about that transition from pop to country, so to speak?
Well, I feel fine about it. It hasn't really seemed like a transition to me. I mean, it's as though country music kind of came to me. I don't sing any different and play any different. I'm still looking for good songs. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, there's only two kinds of music, the kind you like and the kind you don't like, you know.
Well, you're making the kind a lot of folks like. You've had an interesting couple of years since you had your first RCA album here in Nashville. It's gone like gangbusters. I think there were like four big singles off of it, and a lot of touring, too.
Yeah, quite a bit of touring. In fact, I was just got off the road on a Canadian tour with Don Williams, which is really fine. Such a gentleman, and his audiences are just beautiful.
Don likes a good song, too, and I noticed, well, from your first RCA album, you're not afraid to do a song that is a little bit sad, as well as some of the happier, more positive love songs, too. You like real people songs.
Yeah, I'm a hopeless romantic as far as that goes, but I also like songs that I like to say are really about something. You know, songs of substance.
Well, you've got this new album. It's That's That, the second RCA album. And the single, which I think is well in the top 20, Whisper Your Name. Somebody was telling me that they were predicting this is going to be one of those wedding songs that people play at their wedding because it's such a nice love song. You think it will?
Well, yeah, I do. In fact, it was long before I recorded it because Randy Van Warmer wrote that song for his brother, who was getting married, so it was a wedding song right from the get-go.
Well, that's appropriate. You're going to be at Fanfare next week?
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't miss that. I'll be in the booth, and I'll be hanging out, be at a few of the shows, too.
I heard that you have a long trip planned right after Fanfare, going out of the country, right?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to England. Actually, the band and I were just in Amsterdam here a couple months ago, and my wife and I stopped in London to just kind of walk around and see what there was to see. But I'm going over to do a promotional tour here in, about 10 days.
That should be a lot of fun. We've only got a couple of minutes, and I promised Keith we'd try to get you to play a little bit. I know you're not going to do this song on the show, but could you do a little bit of Gimme Wings? That was one of my favorites.
Sure.
He asked her, "What gifts can I bring you to prove that my love for you is true? I want to make you mine forever. There's nothing on this earth I would not do." She said, "Anything I've wanted, you have given willingly. So now there's only one more thing I need. If you love me, give me wings. Don't be afraid if I fly. A bird in a cage will forget how to sing. You can trust me. Give me wings if you really love me. Give me wings. Give me wings.
Great song, Michael. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
What are you going to do on the stage tonight?
Well, it's funny you should ask. I hope I can remember. We've got to do the new single, I Will Whisper Your Name. And then another song, which is on the new album called The Moon Is Still Over Her Shoulder. And then we'll have to wait and see after that.
Well, we're so happy to have you once again for your first time on the Grand Ole Opry, and everybody's going to love it. You folks are in for a treat, too, in a few minutes. Well, there's more fun backstage, though, when Keith sees what's cooking with our gourmet singing star, Jeannie Pruitt, so stay tuned.
This now has crossed over into country and doing a great job. Here again, Mr. Aiken.
Gentlemen moving in back of me here, all of them are strangers to me. I haven't been used to them on the stage. Nice to see all of you, and you look like you might be a group of fine musicians. And the fellow that I'm going to introduce and bring in now, I had to get a little data on him so that I'd know a little bit about him. And when I met him and asked him about it, I hadn't met him until just a few minutes ago, and he said, that's not all true. And I don't know whether I ought to tell all this or not, but I'm not going to try to tell it all. It's not that. But He's not originally, as this note says, from Minneapolis, Minnesota. He says he's a Colorado boy, and he's proud of his state out there, but from Colorado, Minnesota, and Minneapolis, Minnesota. Maybe I ought to go up there and get a lesson. And he's with the RCA recording people, and he's had some fine songs. One of his latest songs was Give Me Wings, and The Moon Is Still Over Her Shoulder. That's some of the numbers that he's recorded that had been great for him. Would you make him welcome? He's a fine young gentleman. I'm satisfied you'll enjoy him. Michael Johnson. Come on here, my boy. You can have that microphone there. Michael, it's good to see you.
Thank you very much, Roy.
Thank you. Did I do all right? Where are you really from?
Where am I really from? I really am from Alamosa, Colorado.
Alamosa?
Alamosa.
Alamosa, Colorado.
Yeah.
Well, we're glad to have you on the show.
Thank you.
I noticed one thing about you. Your strings are different from the other boys' strings. The others have them hard steel strings. They make a lot of noise. You have I call them catgut strings.
Right.
Well,
these are nylon strings.
Nylon.
Classical guitar.
Yeah.
There aren't too many of us.
Well, I'm not familiar with you. I'd have to admit to you, and I don't listen to radio a lot and television a whole lot, but I'm actually waiting to hear you. Tear loose on that and let's go.
I'll do it. Okay.
And two hearts will win. I have loved you as surely as love has no shame. For as long as you're listening, I'll whisper your name. I will whisper your name when you're forever to whisper your name. set the whole world aflame. And they used up the oceans and still prayed for rain. When they cried for the guilty, I'll take the blame.
Here's a song that it's kind of an anniversary song. I like to think of it as such. It was a pretty big record for us, too. It's called The Moon Is Still Over Her Shoulder.
That's what they told me was one of your big ones. Thank you.
She still turns his head and the moon.
stars are still falling above, and she never.
Michael, you did a beautiful job.
Thank you. I enjoyed it. Thank you. You do a fine job. All right.
Michael Johnson making his very first appearance at the Grand Ole Opry, and he's excited about that, too. I interviewed Michael about a year ago on a radio show, and he was telling me at that time, I said, Michael, you ought to come out and do the Grand Ole Opry with us one night. And he said, boy, would that be a treat for me. He said, you know, I've listened, heard about the Grand Ole Opry all my life, and would be real excited to do that if they would have me. Well, by golly, it happened for him tonight, and we want to congratulate Michael Johnson on his very first appearance on the Grand Ole Opry.